Hey everybody, I'm here today to show you how to clean a Nespresso Essenza Mini coffee machine. In this video, I'll be going over the basic simple steps for cleaning this machine. As you can see, this is the Nespresso Essenza Mini, and it is an espresso machine. It allows you to make short and long espresso coffee, and I'm going to show you how to clean it. Now, you should clean it as often as you want to. I can't speak with regards to instructions because it all depends on how much you use it. Now, this isn't a descaling process. That is completely different, and if you want me to make a video on that, then drop a comment below and I'll make a video on how to descale the machine. This is just a basic cleaning. In some other Nespresso machines, they allow you to just run water through the pipes without any coffee being brewed, and that cleans the pipes. As far as I know, that is not possible on this machine, so I'm going to show you how I clean this machine. Let's get right into it. I'm going to roll up my sleeves. First and foremost, you want to remove the three essential components that need to be cleaned. Number one is your drip tray. As you saw right there, it literally just lifts up, okay? So literally just lift it up like that. There's your drip tray. Okay, as you can see right here, you can pop that piece off just like that, and you have all the drips in there. As you can see, it looks kind of gross. This definitely needs to be cleaned. Then you want to remove your capsule container, which is right there. As you can see, once again, check this out. Just like that. You just pull it out. I'll turn it towards you so you can see. You just pull it out just like that. And all of your capsules get stored in there. So that's going to be a little bit dirty. And then thirdly, you want to remove the water tank at the back right here. Just very simple. You want to just pop it out of place just like that. Okay. Now, essentially, you're going to be cleaning those three things right over here. Now, you want to use soap and water, but for the sake of time, I'm just going to rinse them with water. Remember, you want to wash these, all three of these, with soap and water, and rinse them thoroughly, especially this, because you don't want soap in your coffee. So, rinse it thoroughly before you fill it up again. But for the sake of time, I'm just going to be washing them with water. I'm just going to give them a rinse. And this is also a good option. If you're doing this like every week, you can get away with just giving them a rinse. And then like once a month, you can clean them with soap or something like that. Turn on the water just like that. Okay. First and foremost, the drip tray. I just want to make sure you can see this on camera. Yes, you can. The drip tray, pop that off. Okay. As you can see, give it a good wash. I like to use pretty warm water because then it sort of melts off the coffee that's on there. As you can see, without even using soap, okay, I'm just rubbing it with my finger like that. Without even using soap, I managed to get off all of the coffee, which is absolutely fantastic, okay? Now the grate for the drip tray, okay, just like that. The capsule container, you want to make sure that you empty the capsules out. So these come apart just like this, comes apart. I'm going to take the capsule container. I'm going to empty out the two capsules that were in there, and then I'm going to wash both of these components. Okay, just like that. The capsule container has these holes at the bottom of it, and then all of the coffee from the capsules goes into this secondary drip tray. This is for the capsules themselves. So this is not what drips out of the spout when you're done making a coffee. It's for the capsules themselves. And last but not least, the water reservoir. Empty it out. I like to do this, I don't wash with soap every single time. I just do like this. Little swirl of the water, empty it out, and then I like to fill it with cold water. Right? I don't know why. I mean, as I grew up, my dad was raised in a house where they said that the cold water pipes were always cleaner than the warm water pipes because of the sediment in the hot water tank and stuff like that. I know nowadays it doesn't really make a difference the way that things are now, but I've just been raised to sort of put, when you fill something that you're going to consume, just put cold water and fill it up with cold water. That's it. You're going to put it back together. Obviously, you're going to dry everything off, but I want to save some time. So, I mean, this you don't really have to dry off because it's wet anyways. Pop that back on there just as is. Okay. You want to take the bottom portion of the capsule container, put it back just like that. Once again, I'll show you with my hands like this, just like that. You want to slide it back into place, just like that. Once again, slide it back into place, just like that. Take your drip tray, put it back together, just like that. Hook it on, you're good to go. And then if you want, what I like to do as well is I just take a little cloth, paper towel, and I just wipe the actual machine over, just because I know that coffee ends up being on it somehow, it splashes on it and so forth. And that's basically it. I really hope that you've enjoyed this video tutorial on how to clean a Nespresso Essenza Mini coffee machine. If you liked it, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.